Hello and welcome to Solomon's Cave. I have been promising this video for a while now, and here it finally is. This video will explain to you how to distinguish the normal comets from the Comets Khatouf. I first mentioned the Comets Khatouf in the video about vowels, and it took me a long time to get here because you should also be aware of the following aspects of Biblical Hebrew. You should be aware that there are two types of dagesh, and what their function is. And you should also be able to distinguish between open syllables and closed syllables. And, by implication, you should be able to distinguish between the vocal and the silent shavas. Once you got all of those fresh in your memory, you are ready to delve into the comets question. And there are only three things you need to remember. The first one is that almost all comets are normal comets, hence a long A sound. Ah. And then the other two rules are the exceptions for when a comet is actually a Comets Khatouf and hence a short O sound. O. The first kind of situation in which a comet is actually a Comets Khatouf is if the next consonant has a Khatef Comets. That is relatively simple. Here is one example. Oholu, his tent. And now the other context in which a comet is actually a Comets Khatouf. And that is if the syllable is closed. Well, that sounds simple enough, right? You just have to make sure that you can distinguish between open and closed syllables. And then you have it all. Of course, distinguishing between open and closed syllables can be a pain, since you have to keep in mind all the rules about the shavas and the dagesh, and making the proper identification can be somewhat difficult sometimes. But it is what it is. So let's look at some examples here. First this one. It is a very common word. And it is a single closed syllable. Hence, a Comets Khatouf. So you pronounce it as kol, and it means all. And interestingly enough, it can also be spelled with a holon. Now this one. It has two comets, so let's look at the syllables. Let's first divide it up here. And then the last part is clearly open, because a hey cannot close a syllable. So it is a normal comets. But what about the first half? Is it one syllable or two? If it is two syllables, the shwa is pronounced, and both syllables are open, and the comet is long. Or if it is one syllable, it is closed, the comet is a Comets Khatouf, and the shwa is silent. So which one is it? And I must admit, that for all the rules I know about Hebrew, I cannot find a single rule that would definitively prove it one way or the other. Well, except for one. And that is that if you feel like you have to pronounce the shava, then you pronounce it. But if you feel like you can pronounce the word just fine without the shava, then it is silent. So can we pronounce this word without the shava? Yes, we can. Chochma sounds just fine. There is no need to pronounce the shava. So that is the answer here. And chochma means wisdom. So you need some wisdom to pronounce wisdom correctly. Next is this one. And this would normally be an open syllable, and hence a normal comets. But there is a dagesh forte in the nun. This means that the nun is actually double, and that there is a silent shava under the first nun. This actually makes the syllable closed, and hence we get a Comets Khatouf. Choneni, and this means he was gracious with me. So there you go. Those are all the rules for pronunciation you will need for Hebrew. We discussed the consonants, the vowels, the syllables, and then we also distinguish between the two types of dagesh, the two types of shava, and now the two types of comets. And hey, what's that? Guys, I did not invite you here. As if Hebrew wasn't hard enough already. Yeah, that's right. The accents are here. And everything you think you know is going to become even more difficult now. Not that anything I told you in these previous videos is false, just that there is an extra layer to it. And there are even more exceptions now. But that's going to be for the next couple of videos. I will discuss the accents, which ones they are, what they mean, and how they mess up all the rules I've explained so far. But for now I'm going to end this video, If you liked it, give it a thumbs up, and then follow me on social media to stay up to date with news and announcements. And of course, you can subscribe to this channel for more content.